Hello students. So students, we have completed the chapter that is reaching the age of adolescence, and today we will start with the new chapter, the first chapter, and that is crop production. So you see student, the name of the chapter is crop production. So first of all, we should know that what is the meaning of a crop. And before that, we should understand that what is a food, because crop is what is something that we used to eat, so we will include it into our food. And you know that the basic necessity of a life for a organism is the food. Food is very necessary, shelter. Okay, and the food, if we are talking, which is very essential and very important for the living organisms to survive, it is important that food should be distributed to each and everyone in a proper manner. Now, for that, with the increasing population, you see, in human being, the population is increasing day by day. So, the demand of the food is also increasing day by day. Okay, so it is necessary that the crop should be produced, or the food should be produced in a vast amount, so that each and every person will get the food. Okay, or each and every person will receives the food, or they can the basic need. Okay, so we can say that food should be cultivated, and it should be the distribution. The managing of the food also, everything should be done in a proper manner, so that everyone will get the food. Now, if you look, students, that how does this production of the food occurs? How a human being they came to know about it? So, if you look after in the prehistoric period, the people human beings are not knowing how to grow crops. But later on, they understood or growing crop, how can they do this agriculture practices, and then the crop production increases. So you see, we are continuously using the term crop. So what is the meaning of a crop? Growing of a particular type of a food on a large scale, that is known as a crop. So we can write the definition of a crop, that is when a plant of the same kind is grown, when a plant of a same kind is grown on a large scale, on a large scale, that we call as a crop, on a large scale at one place, called as crop. Okay, so what is a crop? When a plant is there that is of the same kind and it grown on a large scale at some places, they are called as a crop. Now, you see students, if we say that crop is there, so we should also know the meaning of another term, and that is agriculture. Agriculture. So, agriculture is what? It is stand for growing of the plants and rearing of the animals. Both of them collectively known as the agriculture. Okay? So, agriculture stands for growing crops, or growing plant, you can say, plants, and rearing animals for what? For food, for clothing, for food, clothing, and other useful product. Okay, so agriculture means what? It is done for growing of the plants. Why we are growing the plant here? We are growing plant to get the food, sufficient amount of food, and animals for clothing, for some other useful products or students we get from that of the plants as well as from the animals. Okay, so we are the agriculture is what? It is a growing and rearing of the animals for food, for clothing, and for other purpose. That is called as a agriculture. Now moving on and understand the term of a crop, that is a plant of a same kind grown on a large scale. Like we can say in case of a crop like rice. So if rice is what? It is a one kind of a plant. If it is a grown on a large scale, if it is a cultivated on a large scale, then instead of using only rice plant, we can use the term that is rice crop. Like that, if the wheat is there, students, so we can say that if wheat plant is cultivated, is grown on a large scale in a particular area, then we will use the term for it, that is wheat crop. So any of the grain, any of the plants of that of the same kind, it means if we are talking about the wheat, so only the wheat plant is there in that particular area, then only we will call it is called as a wheat crop. Okay, so growing of a plant of a same kind on a large scale, that is known as a crop. So this is the definition of the crop, and this is the agriculture. Agriculture is the growing of plant as well as animal, rearing of animals for food, for clothing, and to get other useful products from them. Crop is only for the plant. We use the term the crop for only for plants. We are growing the plants on a large scale, that is known as a crop. So here in this chapter, you can see the name is crop production. So we are going to talk about the plants only. That is how the plants they grow. What are the different types of crops? Types of crops are there, and what are the different agriculture practices that we do so that we get a good amount of food, good amount of crops. So first thing, that is types of crop. Okay, types of crops. Now in types of crops, students, you see that India, it is a vast country, and the conditions, the climatic condition, it also varies from place to place. What are the different climatic conditions we are talking about? So you see humidity, temperature, rainfall, all these are the conditions which decides the type of a crop grown in a particular area. Okay, so whatever will be the climatic conditions were there in a particular area will decide the type of a crop also. And on that basis, we have divided crops into two types, that is rabi crop and kharif. Okay, so let us understand this. That is, the climatic conditions vary from place to place. In India especially, you see that climatic conditions vary from place to place. Okay, and since the climatic condition vary from place to place, like climatic condition, like students, you see temperature somewhere the temperature is very high, somewhere the temperature is very low, then humidity, then rainfall, etc. So these are the different climatic conditions which decides the growth of a crop, and it also varies from place to place. Okay, so crops, they depend upon the climatic conditions. Depends on the climatic condition. Climatic conditions. And that is why the growth also varies. Okay? And on that basis, we can say crops are classified into two. Into two, called rabi crop and kharif. Rabi crops and kharif. So two types of crops are there, rabi crop and kharif crop is there. Okay, now we see the first crop we will discuss here is that of the kharif crop. Okay, so first one is kharif crop. Kharif crops. Okay. Now, if you look here, kharif crop, what are the different conditions for a kharif crop, student? So, basically, kharif crop grown during that of the rainy season between June to that of the October. Okay. So, June to October is the timing for that of kharif crops. So, it is grown in, it is cultivated in June and harvested in October. Okay, so we can write it. They are grown, first point in case of a kharif crop. So it is usually grown in rainy season. Okay, it is usually grown in during rainy season. And they are generally planted in June and harvested in October. Okay. Now, what are the different names of this crops also? That is, they are also known as a autumn crop or monsoon crop. Okay? So, we can write it. These are also called as monsoon crops or autumn crop. Okay, so we can say that it is a monsoon crop or that of the autumn crop. Now there are the different major kharif crops are there, students, which include that of the rice or maize or jawar or millets. All are there, the different crops of the kharif crops. So we can write the different kharif crops. It includes paddy, that is also known as rice, maize, millets, jawar is also there in the millet, or bajra is there, jute, cotton, pulses, then in pulses, the student, a lot of a different kind of a pulses, like that of a groundnut is also there, etc. So these are the different kharif crop. So kharif crop, we have seen one thing here. One, that is, it is usually grown in rainy season. Second one, that it is generally planted in that of the June and it is harvested in October. And because of that, the other name of this crop, that is kharif crop, is monsoon crop or autumn crop. Now the different types of a crop which we call as a kharif crop is a paddy, which is also called rice. Maize is there, millet is there, so jawar, bajra we will include in millets. Jute is there, students. Cotton, pulses. Pulses includes a lot of different types of pulses, like chicken peas there or ground nuts are there. So these are the different types of a kharif crop. Now we will see the another kind of a crop, and that is known as a rabi crop. So rabi crop, it is not grown in the rainy season, but it is grown in the winter season. Second one is rabi crops. So the first point that we will write in case of a rabi crop, that it is it generally grow during the winter season. So rabi crop generally grows during the winter season. Okay, and this crop is duration of this is November to April. Okay, so it is grown into November and harvested in April. So we can write it, generally they are planted in November. Okay, and when it become mature, so it is harvested in April, in the month of April. So its duration is in between to that of the November to April. And because of this season, basically it occur in the winter season, so we will also called rabi crop as a winter crop. Okay, so it is also called as winter crop. Now you see, it is grow or it is generally planted in November, so that is why we can say that it grows during the winter season, and that's why it is known as a winter crop. Since it is harvested in April, so we can use another term for it, that is April is what's the spring season, so we will call it spring harvest. It means harvesting of this rabi crop occur in spring, so we will use the another term for it, that is either it is called as a winter crop and spring harvest. In case of a kharif student, it was autumn harvest, and in case of a rabi crop, it is known as a spring harvest. Okay, so you see that a rabi crop generally it occurs during the winter season, so it is known as a winter crop. Now what are the different crops which we include in the rabi crop? So gram pea is there, then potato, oil seeds are there, potato is there, oil seeds, oil seeds are there, wheat is there, etc. Okay, so these are the different examples of that of rabi crop. So you see, student, what are the things that we have studied in rabi crops? So it generally grow during the winter season, and if we talk about the winter season, so it grow or planted in November, that is the winter season, and it is cultivated, it is harvested in April, in the month of April, and because of that it is known as a winter crop or spring harvest. Okay, and the plants, the crops which we include in case of a rabi crop is the gram is there, wheat is there, pea is there, and other oil seeds, potato is there. So these all are the examples of the rabi crop. Now on the basis of that, student, we can divide or differentiate between that of the rabi and the kharif crop. I hope you have understood the characteristic, and by that you can easily find the difference between these two crop. So you see that if we talk about the kharif crop and rabi crop, so in case of a kharif crop, basically the kharif crop grown during the rainy season, and rabi crop it is grown in winter season. If we look at the kharif crop, so it is basically grown in the month of June, and it is harvested in the month of October. Okay, so it is planted in the month of June. June is what? It is a rainy season, and it is harvested in the month of October. And here in case of a rabi crop, so it is grown or just planted in the month of November and harvested in the month of April. In case of a kharif crop, we use the term that it is also known as a monsoon crop or autumn harvest. And in case of a rabi crop, we use the another term for the crop, that it is also called as a winter crop or spring harvest. The type of crops means the different examples of the crops also help in differentiating that of the rabi and the kharif crop. Okay, so in case of a rabi crop, just now we have seen wheat is there, gram is there, pea is there. In case of a kharif, jute is there, cotton is there, pulses are there, okay, maize is there, millet are there. These are the examples of that of the kharif. So whenever the question is asked that differentiate between the rabi and the kharif crop, on the basis of these characteristics you are able to make the difference between these two. So these two topics are very important, student, that the different types of crops including the rabi and kharif crop. Now let us move and try to understand that next topic. Now if we are talking about the crops, students, so crops are not only divided into rabi and kharif, but it is also divided into two, that is food crop and cash crop. Food crop we can write it like crops, food crop, and the second one is cash crop. So by the name itself you are able to understand, if we are talking about the food crop, so this crop is cultivated, is grown or just planted to for the purpose of food, means the food which we eat. But here the crop is grown for the purpose of selling. Okay, so these crops are sale to get money, and that is why the name is given cash. And here food, so these crops are grown as cultivated for the purpose of eating, so we will call it as a food crop. So we can write it, so the crops grown mainly for the purpose of food. Okay, example, lot of examples are there, pulses are there, wheat is there, maize is there, barley is there, millet is there, potato is there. So all these are what? They are ground oil seeds are there. So these are what? These are the food crops that we use to eat. Okay, so wheat, rice, maize, millets, etc. So these all are the crops which is grown mainly for the purpose of food. If we talk about the cash crop, so these are the crop which are mainly grown for the purpose of sale and profit. Okay, so this is the type of a crop which is used for purpose of selling and getting profit of it. Example, students, examples are cotton. You do not eat cotton, so it is used for selling purpose. Jute is there. Even coffee is there also, etc. Okay, so these are the different types of crops which we have divided on the basis of food crop and that of the cash crop. Now the next topic, if you look, that is agricultural practices. Agricultural practices. Agricultural practice. So, for cultivating a crop, a farmer used to do various activity. Farmers carries various activity so that he will get a good amount of a crop, or he will get a healthy crop, okay, on a large scale. And that activities which is done by the farmer for the cultivation of the crop is known as the agricultural practices. Okay, so we can write the definition of agricultural practices is a farmer do various activities for the cultivation of crop, for a period of a time that is called as agricultural practices. Agricultural practices. So there are different types of agricultural practices. Different types of activities is performed by the farmer so that he or she will get the sufficient amount of food crop. Okay. So what are the different practices? So the first one is the preparation of a soil. Yes, soil provide everything to the crop. So the soil should be what? It should be fertile. So the first one is preparation of soil. Second one is selection of seeds and sowing. Selection of seeds and sowing. Selection of seeds and sowing. Then the third one is manure and fertilizer. Adding manure and fertilizer. Then the fourth one is irrigation. Weeding of the crops also using the weedicides. So weeding and crop production is also very important.
reading and crop protection. Harvesting, after all, harvesting is important. Harvesting, and not only harvesting, but the storage of the food grains also. So, storage of food grains. So, these are the different agriculture practices that is performed by the farmer. The first one is the preparation of soil, then selection of seed is important, and adding the manure and fertilizer for proper growth, then irrigation, and finally you see weeding is important, student, adding the weedicides and protecting the crops. Harvesting, after the crop get mature, we should harvest it, and the storage of the food grain. Not only harvesting, but the food should be stored for future purpose. Okay.